Good afternoon, Standard 9 students. Now we are aware that Farmer Jones had taken John and Mrs. Ellis had taken away Kate for the reasons best known to them. We also know that they were not taken because on sympathetic grounds. They were taken for these two people's own gain and benefit. But no one said, I'll take Maggie. Pitying glances were cast on her wan and wasted form. Everyone did feel sorry for Maggie, but it was of no use. Nobody wanted to help her out. They were feeling sorry for her, no doubt, but at a distance. And thoughts were troubled on her account. Means many people did not know how to react, what to do, although they were feeling sorry for her. Mothers brought cast off garments and removing her soiled and ragged clothes. Now some ladies brought some clothes, used garments, but they cleaned her and they removed the dirty and torn clothes from her body and put in some new ones. Dressed her in clean attire, in clean clothes, the sad eyes and patient face of the little one touched many hearts and even knocked at them for entrance, but none opened to take her in. Who wanted a bedridden child? Now, they did whatever they could do, like giving her clothes, cleaning her up, dressing her up, but that was enough. And when they were doing all this to Maggie, Maggie very lovingly, patiently waiting when one of the ladies will take her into her arms. Okay, she was waiting when somebody will invite her. Like she was trying to knock at the door, but unfortunately nobody wanted to welcome her, or nobody opened the door of their hearts. Okay. So, because who wanted to keep a bedridden child? So, take her to the poor house, said a rough man, of whom the question, what's to be done with Maggie? So when everyone was concerned, what is to be done with Maggie? Everyone suggested take her to the, one rough man said take her to the poor house. That was the answer to the question, what would be done with Maggie? Was asked, nobody is going to be bothered with her. So all of us here, once she's taken to the poor house, then none of us be bothered about or concerned about her anymore. The poor house is a sad place for a sick and helpless child, answered one. So here one of them did not like the suggestion, because the poor house is not meant for a girl like Maggie. For your child or mine, said the other, lightly speaking, but for us, this brat will prove a blessed change. She will be kept clean, have healthy food, and be doctored, which is more than can be said of her past condition. Now the reason for sending her to the poor house was such, since nobody was willing to take a sick child to their house, so they suggested take her to the poor house. Some said it is not the right place for the sick child. Okay, it may not be good for her. But then some of them also said, now when she is taken to the poor house, she will be kept clean. She will get sufficient food and she will be given medical treatment, which she was not receiving in her own house. Because we know that her mother was an alcoholic. She was very, very poor. Maybe these children were being starved. They were wearing torn clothes. According to her past living condition, she would live a better life in the poor house. Now they had compared the child's past living condition and what her condition would be if she was living in the poor house. There she will be better off and taken proper care. There was reason in that, but still it didn't satisfy. Though it was a good reason, the reasoning was good, the suggestion was good, things realized that her life would be better than her past life. But yet some people felt that they were not satisfied with this. The day following the day of death was made the day of burial. Now what the people decided, the day she died, it was decided that that's the day only she will be buried. A few neighbors were at the miserable hovel. That means a few neighbors were there in that tumble-down shack or tumble-down hut or house. But none followed the death cart as it bore the unhonored remains to its pauper grave. Now some of them were there, but once the dead body had left, now the dead body is of an unhonored woman because of the reputation, her image, how people hated her. Okay. And pauper means a person with no money. So it is referred to the death of a poor, miserable, disrespectful woman. So some of them that were in the house did not follow the cart of the dead body. Farmer Jones, after the coffin was taken out, placed John in his wagon and drove away, satisfied that he had done the part. Now according as soon as the dead body left towards the cemetery or graveyard where the lady had to be buried, immediately Farmer Jones caught John and put him into his wagon and drove away, because he did not want that John would feel, become very sentimental and emotional, and then he may not want to go along with him to see his two sisters cry. Okay. So immediately Farmer Jones took away John, and he felt satisfied because number one, he had got a young boy to work in his farm, and number two, he felt that the people had a good word for him, that Farmer Jones is a very kind-hearted man, see how he is helping this lady's son. But many of them failed to understand the underlying motive of Farmer Jones. It was not his decision that he took John, it was his wife who had made that decision to take John with them. Then immediately Mrs. Alice spoke to Kate with a hurried air, means hurriedly. She also did not want that Kate should change her mind. So she says, told her, bid your sister goodbye, and drew the tearful children apart. So she said, why don't you go and tell your sister goodbye as we are leaving. Now both the sisters were crying, and now they have to part with each other. So the separation of the three children were already made. Okay. Like Farmer Jones took away John, Mrs. Ellis is now taking away Kate, and then Maggie was left alone. And drew the tearful children apart, asking, before scarcely their lips had touched in a sobbing farewell, before they could embrace themselves or talk or share their sorrows with each other, because they had just lost their mother. Before all this could take place, Mrs. Ellis knew that it may change. Kate may change her decision of going, and she would be, you know, would want to stay with her sick sister. Hastily, others went out Now, as soon as the dead body went, John went, Kate went, others that were in the house, they also hurriedly left the house because they didn't want to get caught in a situation where they would have to take the little child, Maggie, the sick child, the bedridden child, with them. So to avoid that, some of them hurried away from the house. Okay. Some glancing at Maggie and some resolutely refraining from a look. Okay. Now some were looking at very sadly at Maggie and they walked out. Some were pretending and they were not even turning towards Maggie. In case seeing Maggie's sad face, they may feel sorry and they may take her. To avoid all this, they just left. She was alone, just beyond the threshold. Joe Thompson, the wheelwright, paused. So Joe Thompson was next to the place where the mother fell down and died. He was there. He did not enter the house, but he was there. Okay. And said to the blacksmith's wife, who was hastening off with the rest. The last lady that was about to leave was the blacksmith's wife. So he spoke to her. It's a cruel thing to leave her so. So because now she is the last one. So now it is a cruel thing to leave Maggie alone. The answer came, then take her to the poorhouse. She will have to go there, answered the blacksmith's wife, springing away and leaving Joe behind. Okay, so she said, why don't let her go to the poorhouse. And before that only, she hurried and ran away. That was the manner in which, because she did not want to be left alone with the burden. For a little while, the man stood with a puzzled air. Now, when the blacksmith's wife went, now it's only he was outside the threshold, the girl was inside. Now, he was standing there with a puzzled air, means he was confused. He was thinking what to do, what not to do. So he was quite tensed. He was trying to make a decision in his mind. Then he turned back and went into the hovel again. Maggie, with painful effort, had raised herself to an upright position and was sitting on the bed, straining her eyes upon the door, out of which all had just departed. A vague terror had come into her thin white face. Now everyone left. Maggie, with great struggles, sat upright, and very sadly she was looking at the door in which everyone left her. Her mother, her brother, her sister, and the people who had come one by one, everyone went past through that particular door. Oh, Mr. Thompson, she cried, catching her suspended breath, don't leave me alone. So very sadly, when she saw Mr. Thompson, she said, don't leave me alone. Very sadly, she said it because it was a very sad atmosphere. Her mother was dead. That was already a big reason to mourn, to cry, to be sorrowful. Then her brother left, her sister had left. Everyone that was also good towards her by changing her clothes, dressing her up, giving her food to eat, they also left. So she did not want to be left alone. So she requested Joe Thompson not to leave her alone. So now I shall end over here and continue with the next recording. I'll be sending some notes. Please write it out. Write and learn the question and answers. Okay, thank you.